Spectrum Health recently established the first adult blood and marrow transplant program in West Michigan.
So what does this mean for patients in our area? Today we have Dr. Stephanie Williams, the program division chief, here with us to answer some of the questions. Welcome so much to West. Tell us, what does this mean?
So this is the first program here on the west side of the state. So patients who needed these types of transplants would have to travel either to the east side, to Detroit or Ann Arbor, or around the lake to Chicago in order to avail themselves of this type of treatment.
Wow, that's amazing, because not only is that a journey when you need something very bad, but also it involves family members.
Correct.
And long stays. And I got to think that that would be very costly and just not so convenient.
It does. It adds to the cost, both financially and emotionally, that these patients have to undergo. Sometimes they're separated from their families for a long period of time, and that's the time when they really need the most support.
And not just your friends, but your family, not your family members, but your friends, your church community, all the people who are here. Tell us the types of cancers specifically that you treat.
So in adults, the types of malignancies, and these are malignant disorders, are leukemias. Those are cancers of the bone marrow. Mm-hmm. Myeloma, another type of cancer of the bone marrow, and lymphomas. Both Hodgkin's lymphoma and non-Hodgkin's lymphomas are the primary diagnoses that we treat.
And there are also different types of stem cell transplants.
That is correct. We have different sources that we can collect stem cells from. We can collect them from a sibling, brother or sister, or an unrelated donor that matches the patient. And we can also get them from cord blood, which is a new growing source of stem cells.
Really interesting. And you're saying that Michigan Blood actually has a wonderful program here locally.
Yes.
That allows people to take advantage of these great opportunities.
Yes, and they can help. They have kits that they can mail to you so that you can take them with you. If you can remember that when you're having a baby, take those kits with you that night. And your obstetrician can utilize it. It's actually fairly easy and safe to do.
Mm-hmm. It's only been about a year for me, but entirely remember that process and them giving that information to be able to read about all the advantages to making that donation.
That's fantastic.
It's something I feel that we hear about a little bit more, stem cell transplants and the benefits. Let's talk about numbers. I mean, how many people are actually receiving?
Right. So right now in the United States, about 10,000 patients a year undergo transplantation. Mm-hmm. Those numbers have grown because we are better able to type unrelated donors, and we have cord blood sources now. Mm-hmm. So the total number of patients is growing, as is the age of patients that are undergoing this type of transplant.
We have a diagram right here, and can you just explain a little bit about this so we can more easily understand?
Sure. So this diagram shows you data from the Centers for International Blood and Marrow Transplantation, actually located in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where all the data across the world is collected. This has to do with the United States. And the top line that you see there represents autologous transplants, where the patient serves as their own donor. So we collect the cells from the patient, freeze them, and then utilize those to treat the patients. The bottom two lines, the green line, are related donor transplants, and the blue line is unrelated donor transplant. And the time period is from the 1980s onwards. So you can see the growth in transplants, particularly the growth in unrelated donor transplants. The blue line has actually surpassed related donor transplants.
Wow.
And that's because of the growth in the registry for people who have volunteer like Terry to be part of that registry.
So talk to us about the importance of becoming part of the registry and really how simple it is for somebody to become a part of this registry, because I was really surprised. We had a coworker here who was going through treatments, and so many of us stepped forward, but it's a pretty simple process.
It is. It's very simple. The registry right now, you can either get a cheek swab where they just swab the inside of your cheek, or a tube of blood can be drawn and sent to a place like Michigan Blood or the American Red Cross where they can do the tissue typing. That's then entered into a large computer database. And when they have a patient who needs a transplant, they can just search the database and determine whether or not you're a donor. The areas where we're particularly short on donors are in the minority populations in the United States, so it's very important for us to increase our outreach to those populations to get more volunteers into that registry.
Wow, that's amazing. And to have this here, we know that you've been in town not too long, but you're here basically, you know, to really just make sure that this happens in a great way, that it serves the people of this community. And what are your goals? You know, as we enter a new year,
right.
and you start this and grow it here.
Yes. And we've had great resources at Spectrum. So we've actually started the program in the adult site from the bottom up. They've had a pediatric program for about 10 years, I believe. So we've hired people, we've had them trained, we have a great staff. We started seeing our first patients the end of November in consultation, and we hope to do our first transplant the end of January.
Oh, wonderful.
And there are quite a large number of patients that need this therapy in Western Michigan. So I think we're going to have a fantastic program that's going to be a nationally recognized program.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you're part of the Spectrum Health Medical Group, which, of course, yes. we know is really creating some wonderful opportunities for patients here yes. in our very own community.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Williams. We appreciate the
Thank
information.
You.
We wish you the best of luck with this.
Thank
Anna.
You.
That'd be interesting.
Yeah.
Kind of learn a little bit more once you get going with those well, transplants.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Yeah. yeah. Big blessing in our community.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Thanks, guys.